Hi, and thanks for logging on to the Daily Dvar. Here's a brand new halacha for you, and it's for Friday, the second day of September. Here we go. More laws about Selichos. Selichos are still about 3 weeks away, but we'll give you those laws and then Rosh Hashanah laws as it all comes closer. Selichos is said every morning at daybreak, really early in the morning, and the reason for that is because, although this is not easy for us to understand, God is considered closer in his presence to us in the early dawn hours. So you still could say Slichos at 8:30 in the morning if that's when your shul is doing it, but the optimum setup time is in the early morning, and that's because it's an Eis Ratzon. It's a time when God more readily accepts our prayers. Okay, when saying Slichos, it's better for you to say the Slichos at Shul because there are certain parts of the Slichos readings that are only eligible to be read while you are all there together in a shul with everybody. One of those things is the Hashem Hashem Kel Rachum. That's called the Yud Gimel Midos, the 13 attributes of mercy that God uses when he judges us. And that contains God names in several different forms, and you're not supposed to say them unless you are reciting it with a minyan. So if you are saying Slichos at home, you would have to skip every time that phrase Hashem Hashem Kel Rachum comes up. You're not allowed to say it unless you're with a minyan. Secondly, there are these paragraphs that are written in Aramaic. Aramaic is, well, gee, you would recognize it because usually the words are a little harder to pronounce. They don't sound exactly like regular Hebrew. They're usually often the long paragraphs that are written in Aramaic. You could ask someone just to be sure, are these the Aramaic paragraphs? But anyway, those are not to be said unless you're with a minyan. Again, this is not easy to understand, but the angels that help carry our prayers to God, they only carry our prayers to God when they are recited in Hebrew, not when they're recited in Aramaic. Now, when you're with a minyan, everything is close to God. We don't understand how most of this stuff works. It's like all metaphysical, but this is what our rabbis tell us, that when you're saying in Hebrew, and even in Aramaic, when you're with a minyan, it's easily transported to God for him to be listening. He can hear everything, but we connect better when it's brought up by the angels that are present and God's presence when we're with a full minyan. If you're not with a full minyan, then you don't have the full, let's just call it the transport power of bringing your Aramaic prayers up close to God's presence, and that way it's not brought to him in the way that we want it to, and therefore, it's best to say the Aramaic prayers with a minyan so that it'll be received by God. Again, this is it, I hope it doesn't sound funny to you, and it's not easy for us to understand such things because God is everywhere, always, but we need to put forward our prayers in a way that makes them show that we made them most accessible to God. It shows that we did the full effort. And so, for your Hashem Hashem Kirachim and Aramaic prayers, we are doing our full effort when those are said together with a minyan. Without a minyan, you can't recite them. Thanks for logging on. Log on again after Shabbos for more. Bye bye.